looks like Wolf for Saluna. So mm-hmm. a couple popular characters that have definitely received buffs in the Smash Ultimate. Let's see what we got here.
Yep, good beginning combo by Noah.
Yeah, I like the fact that he backed off there. He recognized that Saluna had edge, so just back off and let him have it.
Right. And Ike at disadvantage, you don't have to force anything. You can just sit there and see what he's going to do.
Yeah, and you can usually react with an air, which covers a third of the damn screen.
Okay. I think he was looking for a roll-in, but Saluna wasn't giving it to him.
Also, the man was at like 70. Is that going to kill? I mean, probably.
If he got the tipper, it might have killed.
So that up tilt losing to Wolf's Nair, damn. That actually makes me angry a wee bit.
Yeah, I think Nair covers his full body.
That's a good hitbox.
Yeah, it's beefy.
Okay, I want that so bad. I respect the hell out of that, yeah. that attempt.
Oh, no
there.
Punish on the side B. Ike is going to be in up smash kill range soon.
Just about, yeah.
Oh, Saluna almost got that extension on the platform. If he got that, he might have killed Noah.
Yeah, that's kind of the weird thing about Ike is that he just kills by straight hits, and you only need one even at mid percent. And you're just done.
Yeah, but the thing is, he can extend his combos with platforms.
With Nair again, yep.
With Nair. He can do Nair, and then Nair again and land on the platform, and then up air, and it kills super early.
Certainly, so you can see the character knowledge of this guy who knows exactly what to go for.
Mm-hmm. Oh, but he's just going to do it. That's Ike with rage.
Yeah, every now and then just toss out an air, see what it leads to. Usually it's death.
Yeah. Ike is pretty good at killing.
Yes, sir. I mean, this character is basically, like, he's got the Wolf Syndrome where he kills off of stray hits, but it turns out if you've got a sword and you've got a really big, like, cloud-esque hitbox, then, yeah, it's not that difficult.
Yeah.
So now immediately a response from Noah to go ahead and take that right away.
That was a nice 33%. Oh, God, Ike off stage. What's he going to do?
Oh, the forward tilt, but he actually had his double jump.
Oh, no, what's he doing? Up smash. Oh, but he got the spike.
That reverse of the up B, that's so unfortunate. I don't know why he actually did it or if it was just that he got, like, clipped by something, so he was facing the opposite direction. But I think the B reverse of that up B actually killed him.
Maybe. The whole time I was like, what's he going to do? How's he going to punish this? And
he got the optimal punish. That's for damn sure. Like, down air is one of Wolf's bad moves, which means that it's, like, a good move for everybody else except for Wolf. And, yeah, whenever he hits it, damn, you deserve it.
Yeah, that Wolf's down there only has a hitbox for one frame, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
That animation for just one frame.
Yeah,
that's
all
rough.
That wind up. Yeah.
I'd like to kind of see a little bit more laser from Noah, because it seems like he's like going in with these aggressive hitboxes. That's all well and good, and the opponent has a sword. So if they call you out, then you're kind of going to get lit up. And that's what we saw at that stock. I feel that that entire stock, Noah was kind of just tossing out moves because he had a stock lead, and he got punished a little bit for it.
Yeah, I think he's respecting Saluna a little bit too much by not abusing laser. He can just go, or he's just running in.
Yeah, look at that. He lasers, he forward smashes, and then immediately dashes towards the opponent. Saluna cocks back with a forward tilt, and immediately catches him right in the face. Just aggressive options rather than being patient and waiting to see what your opponent's going to do. And Ike is kind of just like this is an even game just about, 80%?
Yeah, if Ike gets an extension on a platform, he will kill right now.
Already going for it. He didn't even wait to see if that Nair confirmed. He just tossed out the back air, just like, listen, please.
Yeah.
Give this to me.
He's like, if it hits, it hits. Oh, no.
Good air dodge there by Noah. He needed that one.
And he got the late hitbox of the dash attack, which sent Ike off stage. Oh, no.
Retreating Nair and the up air to finish. Wow. So Saluna died at like 40% of that down air when he was on the edge and gets basically forced from a really bad spot, and he comes back and takes the match. That does not bode well if you are Noah. I think this requires a mentality switch here.
Definitely a switch to his game plan. He definitely needs, like you said, he needs to abuse laser more. There's a thing that Wolf can do when Ike is recovering. If Ike is trying to recover with side B, Wolf can just laser him to knock him out of the charge.
True.
And then
see that.
Yeah. And then he can laser Ike when he goes for the uppie until he gets a good read on the uppie and then just spike it.
Very true. Unfortunately, we're not going to see if Saluna's got that tech because Noah is given the switch to Donkey Kong. What do you think about this matchup? That's how I feel right now. I feel like DK is never getting back. Ever.
Donkey Kong will get clipped by so many things, I feel.
Though if he hit that down air, he would have been a king. Like, just give him the set. If he got that, that was sexy.
I would have been surprised. Oh, he went for the air dodge. What is he doing?
What? He didn't have the double jump. I guess he didn't trust his aerial drift.
Yep.
DeSola with the intimidation suicide.
All right. Gotta make the Ding most dong? Out of it. Yeah, definitely, definitely. He doesn't have any laser to camp with, so going in is the optimal thing to do.
And you can do it safely with back air. Back air challenges a heck of a lot of Saluna's options.
Yeah, there's no reason to do anything risky right now.
Good platform jump back. Tries for the spike. Aggressive. I dig it.
Mm-hmm. Forward tilt one way, miss forward tilt the other way.
That's actually the thing that I was saying. I don't think Dunk Dunk's ever getting back, because the minute this man is put in a situation where he has to up B linearly, then Saluna can just toss out the counter, or he can toss out a neutral air. Both of those cut through DK's card.
Well, Ike's up B takes so long to go through that DK might be able to come back. But I feel like if Saluna edge guards with neutral B, the eruption, it... Oh, is that death? Oh, he smashes out so fast.
That was also kind of an optimistic option with a forward smash. I think he could have gone for down smash and gotten that.
Yeah.
Good aggressive ether there to get it back.
If he knew he was smashing, he could go for up smash.
True.
But
back throw? Oh, couldn't quite get the grab.
But Eruption is really good at two-framing Donkey Kong.
I think it's pretty good at two-framing characters with bad recoveries in general. And DK is, like, talk to DK main. After they introduce themselves to you and after they give you their tag and let you know they're DK main, they'll complain about up B.
Yeah.
But yoke him out, toss him off stage, but you're going to be able to charge up that side B. I think you got to go ahead and go off stage, toss out a few of those back airs to force out that charge.
Mm-hmm.
Or just put your body in the way.
If Noah gets another grab, you can kill Ike. Or just, like, smack him out of the air with up tilt.
Don't need no grab, just toss hands out. But these nairs, though, that's got to be worrisome. Every time DK gets hit with it, it's like, how am I getting down this time? Please. I don't want to play this video game.
Right.
It's like a solid 20, 30 seconds where I can just go ahead and trap your ledge off, or shoot me your landing off. All right, that was aggressive. I think he was trying to go for an up air, not a up smash there.
That's wild.
Yeah, just
all right, here's the edge guard. What's he going to do?
Okay, no. If he punched that, that was dead.
Yeah, I thought he was going to punch.
Again.
Oh, like, that clipped him. All right, he's looking for the neutral air kill.
Back throw? Right,
fling him off.
All right, just take him real deep.
Back air that? No.
Yeah, I trust with the down air. This man's going for style over substance. Finish the stop.
Yeah,
my
that
man.
Back air is definitely the more optimal solution.
I love to see it when characters go for spikes and the like, but yeah, you gotta finish. Ike is a character that can just take you out of zero.
Yeah.
You don't want to get the option.
Yeah.
Get TI mix up. That is so terrifying. There's so many different things you can do out of cargo throw nowadays that, like, how do you DI?
Yeah, I mean, when you see him jumping up like that, you know he's gonna go for the back throw, the cargo back throw.
So you have to DI down and out. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, game three. I'm liking the DK pick. It seemed to work. So Ike on Battlefield, though. That's That's a ban.
I ban that stage every time versus Ike.
Okay, now we get another switch.
Oh, Snake.
So now Saluna sticking with his single character.
All right, I got to play a match, but it was good talking with you for like half a match.
Thanks for stopping by, Pathram, my man.
All right,
go ahead and give this man a follow. I will have to go ahead and hit you up with his Twitter after this one. Two, one, go! All right, so we still got Noah versus Saluna. Saluna sticking with that Ike, and now we got Noah switching to his third character of the set in Snake. Joined on the mic by...
Let It Rain.
Thank you very much for stopping by, my man. Always a pleasure.
Always a pleasure. Good to see you, and good to see these guys have beaten the hell out of each other.
Exactly. Game three, what more can you want? So you've got the full rotation here, as this is Saluna's... Excuse me, this is Noah's third character in Snake.
What were games one and two?
We saw... First, he lost with... God, it's been a bit. Don't ask me this.
Well, interesting to see that they switch off when win.
Wolf game one,
okay.
And he lost. Game two, he won with DK. Game three, he switched.
Now, it's interesting to see people always switch off characters that they win with.
Yeah,
you know, what's going through their mind? Maybe he's just trying new characters, but, like, what's going through his head?
The DK match was kind of, like, close. I feel like he had a full stock lead almost, but it's because, in part, because Saluna suicided at an early percent, 40%.
Okay, so this is going to be, it looks already to be a nice neck-and-neck game going on here.
Certainly.
Both guys, yeah.
Both characters are at kill percent.
And, of course, whoever gets it first is going to have a nice lead and is going to take control of the game. Let's see who can get it first.
So I think I see why Noah's favoring this. He's basically noticed that Ike, as a character, likes to throw out hitboxes with reckless abandon. Snake punishes that. If you touch his shield improperly while he has a grenade, you're dead.
Yeah, I mean, that's a free 10-plus percent. So.
But if you don't have a grenade, feel free. Whack that man's shield, as we just saw there. Saluna taking stock one.
Saluna does have the percentage in that right now. So, I mean, see how much extra credit you can get going into this match on Snake's second stock.
And this is when Snake doesn't want to pull grenades like that. He's pulling grenades defensively, but the problem...
Oh, yep.
Okay, yeah, that's great.
Get the 160.
But the problem is that, I was going to say, when you're down and you're not looking for trades, You're looking to secure that stock. You do not want to give this man extra credit, which is what happened now. And we're seeing that Saluna is running away with it as this Ike is out on the warpath.
Snake's already at over 111%, and Saluna's looking at a pretty clean 20. I mean, with Ike, that's... I mean, oh man, that almost killed. But yeah, an up air, that does the
That'll
trick.
That'll do, yes, sir. Grenades will not save you from that.
Looks like Snake isn't working out for him right now, so he needs to pull out some special trick to get him back in the game. Because right now it's not looking great, but he's taking control of center stage right now.
It was really even stock one, it's just basically stock two. Saluna got in once and then Snake died. That's kind of the story of Snake, though. If you force him at a disadvantage, it's basically how smart are you. Like, Snakes need to be wise to get out of disadvantage. They don't have, like, a way out. That's just free.
Yeah, as he's lobbing grenades right now, and of course he's getting them here and there, but he's getting percent racked up against Saluna.
He's also not upbeat, and that's one thing that a lot of Snakes do. Like, look at this. Saluna is going to go ahead and take the low recovery, and he's going to have to see four recover, but he air dodges.
And of course, the eruption kills the Cypher.
Nikita, yeah, the Cypher. Yeah. Very good point.
So, I mean, at that point, what are you supposed to do? It's definitely, you know, I bet he was probably scared because, you know, you don't get hit by, like, up air. But at the same time, you don't want to get below stage, especially with, like, you know, that eruption? No, thank you.
Exactly.